NIDOG, we've continued to think that one of the best ways to explore the depth of a character is through their relationships. So it became interesting for us to partner these two together and to explore a lot of that through the gameplay, to see them, see how they succeed when you're in control of Joel and partner with Ellie. What choices do you make within that to get through an encounter, and how does she help you as you continue? It really does kind of distill what it means to survive. You know, when you have Joel who's really is just focused on that and has kind of maybe given up on there being anything else, and you combine him with Ellie that has that sense of wonder, you know, I think that taps into a part of us that always wants to, despite how busy our day is, despite like a schedule and work and all these things, that we want to maintain some wonder. So I think all of these emotional contexts resonate with the players. I'm a designer, so it kind of means we're heading up the ideas. You know, our game director kind of has the vision for the entire game, and then we kind of go and get people in different sections. So as a vision holder, you check in with other people that are delivering you content. I'll go and talk to the artists, the programmers, just to see if new features are coming online. And then kind of depends so much on like what stage of the process we are on. Early on in the process, we go through and do some stuff that we call gray boxing, which just means we create some shapes for the levels, just using Maya and just creating very simple geometry with no art, and just to kind of run around and look around and see what it might be like. So it's a lot of working with the team and trying things out and playing sections and giving feedback. I started in the game industry through a company in Austin, Texas, through Aspire. They had a design position, and I applied for it, and we were working on a title, I think, called Sims Stories, which is all about the Sims game. I had a background in theater, and it just was a nice combination to bring story elements and design. I don't know, inspiration can come anywhere. I mean, it's like, you know, like the inspiration for The Last of Us coming from watching the Planet Earth series. You know, just sitting there and watching, seeing this amazing thing happening in our world with the cordyceps fungus infecting mankind, and being like, oh, that would be an incredible premise for a world. And then just exploring that, all the media that exists that is rich on this theme of characters, like even the book City of Thieves is, you know, not, you couldn't necessarily pull anything directly out of that and that you'd see as applied in The Last of Us, but that just that you see this great relationship being formed over time between these two characters, and that just kind of all sits in layers. So yeah, I think just exposing itself to media and brainstorming with creative people, for me that's critical to my creativity, to being in a room with people that have exciting ideas, so one person can say one thing, another person adds a new thing on top of it, and wait, that doesn't work. And just through that, eventually, you're like, oh, okay, like this is something. And in the morning, you had nothing. You're like, ah, oh, and then at the end, you're like, okay, now through a collaboration. I've never made a movie, so I can't compare if it's easier or harder. All I can say is making games is really hard, because sometimes you don't know what's gonna work or not. You know, you have this really great idea, and you come into work, and you're like, "This is gonna be awesome," and you have a lot of people, and you make it, and it's not. You know, and you're like, "That was not very fun," and you iterate and you try again. But maybe one little part of it was, you know, you're like, "Oh, okay, that was really cool. Like, let's dig into that some more." And so you start to peel back the layers on that. Until you find something and you're like, okay, this was, you know, sometimes you have to dig. And at NIDOG, I think we're fortunate in the way that we're willing to do that. You know, we hire the actors, we do the casting, we do the auditions, we do the motion capture, we write the scripts. From the audio to the AI, to the programming, to the testing, to the play testing, to all these things. Anything of this scope, anything of this size, of this takes a lot of people and a lot of hard work. But I think it delivers. Like, I think that all pays off when you have all these all these elements all focus towards the goal of delivering this emotional experience.